Now we have a story to tell, right?
Right!
And our story is about...
this guy named Jonah.
And... and... you think for a minute about the song we just sang.
Oh yeah, we sang about responsibility. Responsibility. hide from the Lord.
He's running away from responsibility.
You said it.
I know.
So what happens next?
Well, he goes to Jaffa.
Jaffa, Jaffa, Jaffa.
To get aboard a boat.
A boat, a boat, a boat.
To sail far, far away.
Mommy, you look that way.
Save me, there's no doubt.
Go we go, go we go.
Get it together, dear. Figure out what's going on. What are these guys telling you? Let's see now. The Lord is giving a clue, right? I've got teaching to do. Boy, he's got teaching on the brain. Okay, let's see. What was next? Oh, yeah. Hallelujah won't fail. Sing your way out of jail. Use your brain to get out of the whale. Oh, I get it! Teach hallelujah, sing whale. No, that's not right. I'll try again. Teach, whale, hallelujah, sing. Oh, I'm getting warm. Teach, whale, sing, hallelujah. Teach the whale to sing, hallelujah. That's it!
Jonah!
Ninevites not destroy their city. You show mercy and compassion as we all should. And you think Jonah would be happy, right?
Right!
Wrong! Are you ready for this? This guy goes out and pouts. He hollers at the Lord for not blowing the city off the face of the earth.
So, in order to show Jonah the meaning of real responsibility, the Lord does this bit with a plant.
A plant, a plant, a plant!
To show Jonah some shade.
Some cool, cool shade.
But the Lord makes it wither.
Wither, wither, wither.
Just to teach old Jonah.
Jonah, Jonah, Jonah.
That everything and everybody is precious in the sight of the Lord.
How many of you would have the courage to do what this woman did with all these kids and with all these musicians? And on behalf of the kids and all of us,
thank you
so much from the wave.
And now I have to say something. Eli, as Jonah, summed it all up, right? It's much more, Jonah that is, much more than a book about a guy and a whale. It's a story about what God is trying to teach his people and what God might want to do in every one of us. And you caught that as we went through the story of the book, didn't you? And in the end, it's about God teaching his people that his desire is that everybody would come to Jesus. You know, you could so clearly see the New Testament and the gospel in the story presented today. It's that way with the whole Old Testament. You can see the new in the old, and the new fulfills the old. See, God was reaching out to Jonah to say, you might think they're nasty Ninevites, but they are not beyond my reach. That translates to the great truth that there's no one beyond God's reach, no matter what we might hold in our hearts. And in the end, the story was much more about what God was doing in Jonah's heart, maybe even than in the Ninevites. To have a follower of God, a follower of Christ, believing that someone somewhere is beyond God's reach is not what God had in mind. So he invites us with him, to extend grace and mercy to everyone with whom we have contact, even the people we think the nastiest. And we'll let you do that homework in your own mind and heart later. Who are those people? And what needs to happen in your heart, in your thinking and speaking toward them? There's another great verse in Jonah, chapter 2, verse 8. It says this: those who cling to worthless idols turn away from God's love for them. Those who cling to worthless idols, meaning anything that might take priority in your life above Jesus, those who cling to those things, in essence, if God's over here, they do this. That's not smart. So what God was doing in Jonah, God wants to do in us. What God was doing in the Ninevites, God wants to do in us. What in your life might be vying for priority with Jesus? That's an idol. And we'll let all of us do that homework on our own sometime later today as well, remembering that those who cling to worthless idols turn away from God's love for them. Let's pray together. God, thank you for the leadership of these students and children, these followers of Jesus on the platform today. Thank you for the effort that they put into this. Thank you for the rehearsing and memorizing and rehearsals together as a whole group. Thank you for the way that you have used their message in us today. Grow us all up in you, God, that we might learn the lesson that you wanted to teach Jonah, that there's no one beyond your reach, and that we might more and more identify the idols in our own life so that we might no longer turn away from you, but toward you. Thank you, Jesus. Work that out in us today. We pray in your name. Amen.